Alright, so we got a seal in the spot I want to fish. We got a few gill netters. Thank God they're offshore. Those are pretty much my two biggest nemeses to surf fishing. We also
have a nice, pretty sunrise, though.
See if we catch some fish.
I'm glad I woke up. I'm so tired, I can't even freaking handle this line right now. Oh, this is not easy. Fly fishing first thing in the morning. Rough business.
Here we go, though. At least the fish are here and they're cooperative.
See ya.
Oh, it smells nice and fishy here. Oh man, this is gonna be ridiculous.
Lots of fish right in front.
Fish. Little one. Oh, good thing I got the barb crushed on this hook. Should be real annoying. Definitely be poking myself real hard this morning. Cause I'm a mess.
It's on my line. Jeez.
Get it together, Tim. So I was able to pull myself out of bed because I knew there wasn't going to be much wind.
And this is perfect. It's freaking ideal.
And the fish are here. Oh man. a little fish. Oh yeah, decent, pretty, gorgeous. He's pooping. What you pooping? Don't poop on me. Now they got the hang of it. This ain't so bad. Started off real rusty, and now it's just on fire.
Speaking of on fire, I had my finger. Boy, it's cold, man.
Like I said, thank God for barbless hooks. If you're not using them, I recommend you do. 622. See that boat out there? That's a gillnet boat. You can see the black flag. The black flag of death. Not a fan. Those guys literally come right onto the shoreline. Like their flag, I could be casting and hooking their flag right now. And once they come in with a freaking army. And you have black flags and nets every like 100 or 200 yards. And then there's just no possibility for surf casting whatsoever. I've seen them massacre like entire schools of fish. Couple years, well, all right, I just had a nice big boil on my fly on top. Anyway, a couple years ago, I was fishing a spot nearby here. Popular spot, very popular spot. There's an inlet. And two boats, or it was just one boat's net. He set it up pretty much right outside the inlet while there were 15 to 20 pound blues cruising through right on shore. I hooked one, got it in. Incredible fight. As soon as they saw me hook the fish, they dropped their net right in front of me. Defeated and net the entire school of bluefish. Thing is, they didn't even want those bluefish. The bluefish filled the entire net. There must have been 1,000. We're talking all trophy blues, 15 to 20 pounders. One crew couldn't pull it into the boat by themselves, so they had another boat come and help them. Two boats out of Hampton Bays. And they were pulling in the net, and I could just see all the fish were dead. And they didn't want them, so they just threw all the dead fish overboard. Trophy blues. So depressing. Those bluefish littered the shoreline for weeks to come. For miles. Tell you what, gill netting is not sustainable form of fishing.
completely inhumane.
Oh yeah. Oh man, it felt really good.
Pulled real hard. I guess on the outflow. Alright, that's my biggest fish today. Felt like it too. Fought like it.
That's so good.
Oh yes.
Ooh, that hurt.
Nice man. Good looking fish. Beautiful. See bub.
So this was a pretty exceptional April session on the ocean. I tried again in the afternoon with my friend Matt, and we did pretty well, but it wasn't as on fire as this was. I did catch my personal best striper on the fly, though. I'm recording this the following morning, and I was only able to buy one hit this morning. I didn't hook up at all. I'm thinking the stripers may have moved east, so I'm gonna have to start checking some other spots, most likely the back base.